Right, son, now.
We cannot look at Christ as we
look at him. Over to you.
You know what I mean? We all follow Christ.
I'll let you go first.
Let's see, can I get this?
Why are you acting so right? You're more bad for me.
I need to.
I love you, bro. I love
you. It's getting you both in on this.
You're not intimidating, are you?
Come on, man.
Yeah.
Jake, could you hold that? Okay, go for it.
Go on, swear on Holy Bible. Right. Allah,
you go first. You go first, bro.
Okay. In the name of Allah, the merciful, the compassionate. Now, I am a Muslim and you are Christians. Okay. I cannot accept that when you say you give names of three persons, but you say it is one God. Okay? To me, three is three, two is two, and one is one. Look at us Muslims. When you listen to us Muslims, when you read our Quran, it tells us God Almighty, he says Allah. And he is only one. Okay? He has no partners. Okay? One God. So, as a Christian, do you believe that there is one God or more than one God?
Okay, can I answer now?
Yeah, go on.
I believe there's one God and three persons. That's what we believe. We believe that because the Bible says it. The Bible teaches that God is one, that God is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Now we're talking about the Quran and the Bible, and you're showing that the Bible is inconsistent because you're saying it's not consistent about the Trinity. I want to say, first of all, that the Quran has changed. The Quran that you have today is not the Quran you have. Because we have in Surah Sayyid.
I don't know.
Sayyid Bukhari, volume 6, 61, 556. Sayyid Bukhari, volume 6, 61, 513. Sunnah Abu Dawud, 3, 1015. Sayyid Bukhari, volume 6, 61, 514. Sayyid Bukhari, volume 6, 60, 468. Sayyid Bukhari, volume 660, 467. Sayyid Muslim, 1719 to 1802. Sayyid Bukhari, volume 6, 61, 527. These verses show in the hadith that Muhammad couldn't remember the Quran.
No.
So how can the Quran be passed on from generation to generation when the Quran couldn't even be remembered by Muhammad?
Okay, let me answer.
Thank you.
The Christian gentleman said that our prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, who could not remember the Quran. But let me tell you, in the world today, there are millions of Muslims, old, young men, women, who know the Quran by heart. And the first one to learn the Quran by heart was our Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And never at any time did our Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, forget the Quran, either the whole of it or part of it.
Okay, the next thing, I gave loads of evidence for that. The next thing is the Quran, Muhammad borrowed lots of material from other writers. He was like a DJ that got music
and mixed. He was a prophet, not a DJ.
He got music and he mixed it together. Let me explain. The Tayammum 443 copied from the Jewish scripture, the Talmud. Breathing life into birds in Surah 2, 260, 349, 5110, copied from the Coptic books. Hori Hazel, 54454, learned from the foreigners in Mecca. Harut and Marut in chapter 2, 102, in the Quran, from the Armenian books, Harut and Marut in the control of wind and rain. Hello! Allah's throne above water in Surah 11:7 from Jewish tradition. Malik, the ruler of hell, in Surah 43:77 from the Jews. Leviticus chapter 18, 21. Seven heavens in chapter 2 of the Quran, 29 and 41, 12 of the Quran, adopted from the Sanskrit scripture of the Hindus. Mary giving birth under a trunk of a tree in Surah chapter 9, 23, copied from the gospel infancy of the apocryphal Christian gospel.
Okay,
Muhammad borrowed literature from various writers. Okay. It did not come down from heaven. It was a DJ mix from various other
people. Again, you're insulting. I said, don't use the word DJ. Okay, he was a prophet.
Yeah, but he said Jesus is a man.
Me. Is he speaking or you are? One Muslim speaking from this side.
Yeah, but you interrupt.
Again, you are speaking.
Yeah, but you interrupt.
Again, did I? He spoke.
Come.
Okay, you said. You said that the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he copied. Are you trying to tell us that Muhammad, peace be upon him, he copied? In other words, he wrote down.
Yes.
But Muhammad, peace be upon him, he was an ummi. He could not read, he could not write. So where did you get your education from?
You have hadiths, if you go check it, you have hadiths where he asked for the pen.
We know.
We asked for the pen.
Okay, do you know your Bible?
Yes.
Okay, what's in our Quran? And let me tell you, our Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he never wrote down any of the ayahs. He never wrote down any of the surahs. Why? He could not read, he could not write. He was an ummi, okay, unlettered. But who wrote the Quran? Our Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he dictated to 43 different Muslim companions, Sahaba, who knew how to read, how to write. So Muhammad, peace be upon him, what was revealed to him by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the angel Jibreel, okay, he was able to memorize. He did not write down. He was able to memorize. And I'm going to finish. And what he memorized, he dictated to 43 different companions, Muslim Sahaba, who wrote it down as the Prophet told them. So let me get the record straight. Our Prophet never wrote anything down. Okay?
Okay. Just check the hadiths. Go and Google the hadiths and you can find out for yourself.
Don't worry,
now,
we know.
Now we got to deal with the manuscripts. Now we got to deal with the ancient manuscripts. In the top copy, Musaf, Dr. Emeladine says this: we have none of Uthman Musaf manuscripts. Dr. Taya Alok says no serious scholarly work has been done on them. These Musafs date from the early 8th century. He says 22% of the Quran missing. The Samarkand manuscript: undisciplined spelling, scribal mistakes, copyist mistakes, 66% of the Quran is missing. The Hosai Quran manuscript, Dr. Taya Al-Kulak says this is not Uthmic. Paris Petromolopoulos says 74% of the Quran is missing.
Okay.
This has been verified on Islamic Awareness, an Islamic site, and I've also verified it on a secular site called Quranic Corponia. Listen,
let me finish.
So, these ancient manuscripts, we don't have a full ancient manuscript of the Quran. They've been corrupted by, they have textual variants. So to say that it's been preserved and passed on and it's perfect today is gobbledygook.
Okay, let me tell you.
It's gobbledygook.
Let me tell you, our Quran has no mistakes. Okay, our Quran has no contradictions. But let me tell you, in your Bible, on camera, the contradictions, the mistakes in your Bible. Now, I'll give you one example. In the second book of Samuel, chapter 21, verse 8, it says, Michal, the daughter of, excuse me, it says, Michal, the daughter of Saul, who, M-I-C-H-A-L, Michal, the daughter of Saul, She had how many children? She had five sons. How many? She had five sons. But in a different book, in the same Bible, second book of Samuel, in a different verse, what does it say? In the second book of Samuel, chapter 6, verse 23, it says, Michal, the daughter of Saul, up to her death, she never had children. So my question, in the same book, second book of Samuel, in chapter 21, verse 8, it says, Michal, the daughter of Saul, she had five sons. But in the same book, second book of Samuel, chapter 6, verse 23, it says, up to her death, Michal, the daughter of Saul, she had no children.
Okay.
So which one is true?
Okay, did you notice he didn't read out the verse, all of the verse, clearly? I'm going to read out some verses clearly from the Quran. It says, created man out of a mere clot.
Read that verse out.
Listen.
Read that verse out.
Let me finish.
No, you said I didn't read that. Go back to that.
Let me finish.
Why not? You're running away from that word.
Let me finish.
Go to that word.
Just chill. Take a chill pill. It says, created man out of mere clot of congealed blood. That's Surah 96, verse 2. It says, we created man from sounding clay, clot then clay. Then he says, the multitude of Jesus before Allah is that Adam, he created him from dust. So clay, clot and dust, he was created. Then this God is schizophrenic.
You're not answering the
because he don't know what he's talking
you.
About. Here
that's
it is.
Go back
here,
to
let
the
me finish, let me finish. He says he has created man from a sperm drop. So it's clot, dust, sperm drop. That's four verses. I've read the Quran perfectly.
Quran
contradiction.
Quran is perfect.
Well, deal with that then.
Excuse me. You never answer my question. Tell me, did Michal have five sons or did she have no children after her death? How many?
You would have to read the text.
Answer.
Read it to text. Read
okay,
the text.
Read it to
you
us.
Read it. You read it.
You read it.
You read the text.
And your point you make is you read it.
Excuse me. No, I read to you. I want you, a Christian, to hold your Bible and read it.
It's your chance. Speak.
Hey, can you imagine a Christian not accepting the Bible? Why? Okay. Okay. Answer the question. Again.
Make the point.
Okay, brother.
Make the point.
Okay. Another one. Another. I'm telling you, read. It's your Bible.
It's your turn to speak.
Why don't you read?
It's your turn to speak.
I read it. It's another one. Do you still believe, as a Christian, that in your Bible, Christian Bible, there are no contradictions, no mistakes?
Yes.
Are there mistakes in your Bible? Yes or no?
No.
Are there contradictions in your Bible?
No.
Yes or no?
No.
Let me give you another one. You can ask me any number of contradictions, I'll give you. In the first book of Chronicles, chapter 18, verse 4, it says, in the first book of Chronicles, chapter 18, verse 4, the Bible says this, and David took from him 1,000 chariots and 7,000 horsemen. Seven thousand horsemen. But
the battery's
in the second book of Samuel, it says, and David took from him 1,000 chariots. Same as Chronicles. 1,000 chariots. Same. But it says, and 700 horsemen. So my question, how many horsemen did David take? 7,000 as first book of Chronicles says, or 700 as second book of Samuel says?
If you look at the Old Testament, there are Old Testaments in the Septuagint, Greek and in Hebrew. So sometimes there can be a mistake in the translation. So it's a mistake in the translation. Okay. Let me finish.
Christian Bible. No, take the Bible.
No, I'm making my point. You made your point.
So you said there are mistakes to in the Bible. One Christian.
Let me finish.
You put it in the conversation.
One Christian.
Let me finish.
Let him have his speech.
Okay, right.
Bro. Let me finish.
Why don't you read the Bible?
Let me finish.
So how many? 7,000 or 7,000?
I've explained it very clearly.
You haven't?
It says here in Surah 2:256, let there be no compulsion in religion. And then it says in Surah 9:3, proclaim a grievous penalty to those who reject faith. So the contradiction, no compulsion, penalty if you reject faith. Let me finish my point. The historical Jesus. The Quran says Jesus did not die on the cross.
No.
We have historical evidence.
So you
we have Pallas AD 52. Hey. We have Suetonius AD 69 to 140. Tacitus 56, 120. We have Lucian of Samosia, Celsus, Josephus, the Jewish Talmud, all say that Jesus died on the cross.
Are
so
you
the Quran
us?
Is not the word Jeez. Of God.
Okay.
Because it's not historically reliable. Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord. Hallelujah.
No, he was a prophet. Allahu Akbar.
Jesus is Lord. Hallelujah.
Allah is the greatest. He's the creator.
Christ is the greatest.
Okay. You just said that Jesus died. Yes?
Yes, bro.
Are you telling us that God Almighty died?
Let me answer the question then. Can I ask you the question? You believe the Quran, listen, you believe the Quran came from eternity?
No. Answer my question. Listen to me, bro.
I'm answering it. You believe the Quran came down through Gabriel, then to Muhammad, sticks, stones and bones, and then it was written on paper. Uthman burnt the paper. Listen, that doesn't
work. You're running away.
Let me finish. The eternal word became paper. Okay. The paper burned. Doesn't destroy the word. Listen, Jesus is the eternal word, and when his body died, it didn't destroy God.
You are losing.
Simple.
You are losing. Okay,
we'll let the audience decide.
Okay, excuse me. We'll let the audience decide because you are not answering my questions. Okay, the contradictions I'm giving you. Now, can I ask you? As a Muslim, I believe in the Quran. As a Christian, do you believe in your Bible?
Yes.
In your Bible, in the Gospel according to Matthew, it talks about God. In the Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 6, verse 6, it says God. He talks about God. The Father said, who is unseen. What the Bible says, God who is unseen. In other words, God, nobody has seen him. My question, if Jesus was God, did the people see Jesus? Yes or no?
They got spirit.
Can you see God's spirit?
No, one Christian.
What he's on about is you can't see the full glory of God. You can't see the full glory of God.
No, I
that's
said
what
you
that's what he's on about.
Let me finish. No one. Your Bible says no one has ever seen God.
Well, there are many verses. You've got to read many verses, bro.
Well, what about this word?
Let me finish.
What about this word?
Let me finish. It's my point now. You've had your point.
No, you're not answering my question.
I've just answered.
You're losing the debate.
I've just answered.
Okay,
in Sahih Muslim, volume 4, in 4418, it says the stoning verse.